So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight.
Hey guys, it's me again, Patriot Prepper. It's Sunday again. I figured I'd do another talk with you. Let me get this adjusted while I'm driving. Kids don't try that at home. Camera adjusted there. Okay, I want to talk to you. It's about some of the things that's going on right now with me and what's going on in the world. Right now, we got the Olympics going on in Rio. There was a big stink over who was going to carry the American flag out. I don't know who did, because I don't watch that stuff. It's just don't interest me. I haven't been interested in it in a long time. There was a big stink about who was going to do it, and it was... There was supposed to be a... Michael Phelps, I believe is his name. I told you, just don't hold it against me. I don't watch that. He was supposed to carry the American flag out. His teammates voted on it, and they decided it's best that he carried it out since he won all the medals and everything. Then there was a stink going on about, well, should we let this Muslim woman carry it out and show that we are unified and blah, 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 because she's a Muslim and we need to show the world we're united. Well, this Muslim woman hadn't won a medal at all, okay? As far as I know. I could be wrong. Well, one of the event that she's in, she wears this freaking head covering crap called a hijab or hijab or hijababa or whatever, I don't know. It's all gobbledygook crap to me, I don't know. She wears that while she's fencing. And the world just, oh my god, she does this while she's wearing this headdress, ah! Well, big deal. It evidently don't make her fence better because she didn't win. The Olympics are supposed to be about who is the best athlete in that event in the world. And that's what we're losing focus of. We're all focusing on, well, she wore a headdress, or whatever. There's something else I have to talk about with the Olympics. Give me a second, I'll think about it. Anyway, I'm thinking about that. I'm working on freedom and liberty still. I got the lower completely together, as I told you before. I got a AccuWedge coming. I ordered that yesterday. And for those who don't know, what the AccuWedge does is there is some slack in between the upper and the lower on the ARs. There's a little bit of slack, it's not much, but me being the person I am, perfectionist I am, I want it done perfectly. I don't want no slack. So I ordered this little piece to stick in there. I'll show you when I put it in what it does, explain things and everything. There was a lot of things going on this week. It's hard for me to remember, I'm working so much. Right now my mind's going on what I'm going to do when I get into work today. There's flooding down in the south, where I came from, South Mississippi, and I heard there's flooding down there. My thoughts, my prayers are with them. Here, where I'm at in Indiana, it's been in the 90s. The other day, I was going into work, 10:30 in the morning, and it was already up to, sorry, I'm still sleepy. I ain't had a monster yet to wake up. For you may hollers, I know they're bad for you, but I love them. You guys have your coffee, I have my monster. Don't judge me. I was going to work at 10:30 in the morning, and it was already 88. Oh, people. But I still ain't remember what I wanted to talk about with the Olympics. But America did bring home the first gold medal of the Olympics. It was for a young lady shooting. It would have been kind of sad if we hadn't, since we're so, as the world sees us, gun crazy, which I don't understand that, but whatever. I've got a really good close friend over in England who's talking about retiring over here to America. And he informs me, if he gets over here, me and him are going gun shopping. Because the gun stores over there, the gun clubs and ranges and stuff, don't have the guns like we do. I've showed him pictures from the internet of different places where you can go get guns at, gun stores and stuff. Like Cabela's and stuff like that, and he about had a heart attack. He informed me that he's going to become a kid in a candy store when he comes over. My mother, she got her driver's license changed, so tonight when I get home from work, we are going to sit down and start the process of getting her concealed carry. Once she has that, then we will start looking at what handgun she wants. She's already made up her mind on a caliber. She wants a 38 special. So we're going to start looking around for that. I think she's kind of leaning towards the Taurus M85 or the Arms Corps. She likes the feel of them in her hand. So that's where we're at with that. Oh. A few things I'm holding back off on the Freedom Liberty Bill. I'm deciding on my barrel length. I'm trying to decide between 16 and 18 inch. I know I do want to go with a stainless barrel. Deciding on the the foregrip, I want to go vertical or I want to go a angled foregrip. I know I'm going to go free floating with the barrel cover. Bolt carrier group. I kind of like the idea of the nickel boron, but that's going to cost a little more. I don't really know if it's worth it or not, so I'm trying to do some research and find out about that, if that's going to be worth it. The ejection port cover, I've already got one picked out that I'm getting. The forward assist, that's a no-brainer. Muzzle brake, I think I've got it picked out. I'm going to see if I can't find the one I like in stainless. PSA red dot scope for the optics already. I bought it the other day. Bought it Wednesday when I got paid. That's where I'm at with that right now. Anyway, look at the timer. This is going on 9 minutes. I believe I'm going to call this video and done. This Patriot Prepper reminding you, don't tread on me, and I won't tread on you. Have a good day. Sorry, it was 10 minutes.